Assalamu alaikum students. I hope that you are all doing good at your homes. The topic that we are going to study today is non-living things. Before that we have studied living things. I hope that you had previously revised your lecture and you remember what living things are. In the previous lecture we learned that all living things need food to eat, water to drink and air to breathe. In order to live, they need food, water, and air. Today we are going to learn about non-living things. So students, just like we learned about living things in the previous lecture, they need food, water, and air to breathe. Non-living things, they do not need food, water or air. Non-living things, they don't need it. They do not, they don't need food or water or air to breathe because they are non-living. They don't need all of these things. The difference is that living things need food, water and air, but non-living things, they do not need food, water or air to breathe. Okay, non-living things. Non-living things are all around us too. A non-living thing does not need food, water or air. A non-living thing cannot move by itself, reproduce or grow. That means that a living thing cannot move by itself. If a teddy bear like this is placed on a table, it won't move by itself until unless you do the effort and you pick it up and you place it somewhere. It will not be able to move from one place to another with the help of something or somebody. So, and just like a shoe, just like a pencil, just like a cup, just like a dress, anything that cannot move by itself is a non-living thing. It needs help to move from one place to another, and it does not reproduce. Means if it cannot move, so it cannot make babies. It cannot, this teddy bear cannot make copies of itself. It cannot make a small teddy bear or a big teddy bear. It cannot make anything. It's shoes, they cannot be, if there is a pair of shoes at your home, they cannot make another pair of shoes by themselves. You have to buy things. You have to buy non-living things. You cannot buy living things, but you have to buy non-living things. Or grow, they cannot grow. If you are going to buy a pair of small shoes, they are going to remain small for the rest of their life. They are not going to grow. If you are going to buy a pencil, it does not grow. If you are going to sharpen it, it's going to become less, but it is not going to grow. Similarly, a dress will not grow, a cup will not grow. So these all are non-living things because they do not need food, air or water, and also they cannot move by themselves and they cannot reproduce or grow. Okay students, so now the hands of a clock move. As you see, you must have seen in your home, there's a clock and which has three needles and all of them are moving throughout the day. So do you think that the clock a living thing or not? This is your question for today. You have to revise what a living thing is, non-living thing is, and you have to answer this question. You have to write down the answer of this question in your notebook. So I'm going to see you in this next lecture. We are going to revise. We are going to be starting a new topic in the next lecture. Till then, you should just revise living things and non-living things. And I'm going to see you in your next lecture. So take care and have a good weekend. Have a good day. And I hope that you're keeping yourself clean. And I hope that you all are safe. So I'm going to see you in your next lecture. Take care. Allah Hafiz.